like physical factors, climate, soil, topography, and minerals. If these are suitable for generation, then the land is used in a proper way. There are other factors such as human factors. Human factors means depending upon the population and technology. So day by day the population is going on increasing and the technology is also expanded. So the population is using much of their technology and utilizing in a proper way.
Soil. Okay, so this is also one of the
the reason for the formation of soil. Then relief. Relief means the land is not everywhere same. It is uneven and distributed, not in the same everywhere on the earth. So it depends on the mountains, plateaus, plains, the type of soil and the weathering process. Everything depends on the relief features. So this is the various factors of formation of the soil. Next, so soil is also very important to grow the crops. As we know, it is a very important soil, a very important natural resource, and it will take some millions of years to form such a fertile soil. So we need to conserve this soil, isn't it? So there are certain methods of soil conservation. First one is mulching. It is a process. These are all the methods of soil conservation which are adopted by the farmers or farming activities or agriculturists. So first thing is mulching. Mulching is a method where the straw is used in between the plants on the bare ground. This straw is just kept like that in order to maintain the soil in moisture. Okay, so that is called as mulching. Second one is counter barriers. Counter barriers means the grass or stones or some mud is kept like a barriers. That is, trenches will be made on the land in order to protect the soil from the rain wash. Next, rock dam. Rocks are piled into barriers and it will protect the soil erosion and rain wash. This is called as rock dam. Rocks are piled around the barriers. Next, terrace farming. Terrace farming, this is suitable only in the hilly slopes where the most of the vegetation is done on the steep slopes of the surface. So terrace farming means there will be the continuous farming. There will be having some layers of farming methods. It is adopted only in the hilly areas. As you can see in the tea plantations or coffee plantations, mostly it is done in the hill slopes, which requires very less amount of water and it will retain the soil from the erosion or rain wash. Next is intercropping. Intercropping means at a time there will be two or three plantations or cropping methods will be adopted so that one crop is finished, means it can be harvested and the next plant will be retained like that. So this method is adopted because to retain the soil moisture as well as the fertility of the soil and to prevent the soil erosion. Next, counter plowing. It is made to in a farming method, one of the part of this conservation method, that is plowing, counter plowing. So how the counter barriers are there, like that only, counter plowing. Then shelter belts. Shelter belts are those which are done in the coastal areas or dry regions where the huge trees like coconut trees or any long trees, lengthy trees will be grown on the coastal areas as a counter barriers. So this is mostly suitable in the coastal areas like Kerala, Tamil Nadu. So wherever the vegetation is possible in the coastal areas, there these shelter belts are used. So this is called as shelter belts. So these are the methods of soil conservation. So these are very important. So I hope you understood these two natural resources today. In the next part, I am going to explain about water, naturalization, and